Oh. Oh my god.
Welcome back, everyone. This week we're at Baxter. So I didn't go to the Black Diamond Hard Enduro because I was looking at their stuff and looking at the videos of what the trail is going to be like, the track's going to be like, and I was like, you know what? I know my own skill and I know I'm not good enough to do this, and if I do go, it's going to be a long drive to fail miserably and just smash my bike up on the like the morning class. There was like a, I saw some like hill climbs where there's like a rock garden going up a hill. I'm like, oh my god, that to me looks insane. Just as a just to try and get up on a normal day, let alone during a race where there's going to be like 100 guys starfished all over it. Like, no thanks. I need to improve my skill significantly before attempting an event like that. Yeah, holy shit, nah. And then I just don't think I don't practice enough to be able to do something like that. If there's nowhere nearby, like, as much as I'd love to, like, what, I have to drive probably to where the cord is? Those are like that kind of area to be able to find stuff like that. Maybe like, well, Somerville, there's stuff at Somerville which could probably help me practice that kind of stuff. So 2.5 hour drive, 5 hour drive just to basically there and back to try and, you know, get some practice in on that stuff. Bloody hell, nah. I wish like I lived in a place where I could just pop out in the garden and, you know, out the back and just rip around on my bike for a little bit and stuff like that. But there's nowhere that I can have a hill climb with rocks and stuff to practice accurately riding up. So that kind of stuff is just way too hard and way too intimidating. So I'll leave that to the guys from Quebec to have a great day on. I mean, the trail looked so cool, but I know my skill and I know that I'm just going to come back with a massive repair bill, and I don't have infinite money, so yeah, nah. If I did, I mean, I'd just buy a place, live in the countryside, have rocks, ride around on all day, but yeah, no, that's not the thing. Having said that, like, if I was to live somewhere else, you know, you could just move, like, oh. When I very first went for a ride off-road, it was, like, in Thailand, and a lot of their stuff, their hard stuff was like that. I have no idea how to do it, but I didn't do it. Like, they just took me along the trails alongside it, and then they would send other people in the group, because the was like an expert group, and those expert group would go up those rocks, and I was just like, oh my god, what am I watching? So I know that's kind of cool. But yeah, anyway, today I'm with Chris. Everybody else wasn't able to make it, unfortunately, or change their plans. But it was pretty hot and humid out today. Chris was absolutely flying at the start, like a little too hard. Give himself really bad hand cramps and arm pump and stuff. Need a warm up, man. I did some service on my bike this week, oil change and stuff, and yeah, so you can see here, I was like, well, I mean, I'd stopped, but I was fiddling with that because, I guess as I changed the spark plug out, because you got to take the tank off to change the spark plug with the beta, annoyingly. I mean, maybe, like, if you had, like a tool, I can't really get my tools in so great to get the spark plug out. And so I just take the tank off, but I guess I didn't plug it back in, or it was a little loose. So the power changey button, the weather map, the power map, that's it. Got there in the end, the power map was set to, wasn't plugged in, I guess, or it was loose. So it was off. And I think it was in like rain mode, because that's what it felt like. So whilst the bike was putting the new spark plug in, like whilst the bike pulled really, really nicely in low revs in third, really smoothly, like no need of the clutch whatsoever. Riding along, when I gave it some throttle, it was quite gentle, which is obviously what you want in rain mode. But now I turned it back on, I was like, oh, well, why I say I turned it back on, I fiddled with it and it came back on, I was like, oh, sweet. And now, yeah, you go, saw the blue light. And now it's like, oh yeah, there we go, the bike's working good. I have like the BCE CM B8R, something like that. I can't remember the silly names. I didn't know the name, so unfortunately Lang sent me the wrong one. I had a spare. I always have just one spark plug spare. It seems like a good idea, right, with two stroke. So I used my spare rather than putting a new one in. Well, I mean, it is a new one, it's a spare, but like, yeah, the one that they sent was a little tall, unfortunately, so I couldn't get the thing in. But I'm not sure if I was just being like silly, and but it like the pin is like right up against the top of the frame, and I'm not entirely convinced I can get that like spark plug boom over the top. I tried for a couple of minutes and just like, I think this is just the wrong size, and then when I compared the size to the other one that I had, I was like, yeah, it's quite a bit bigger. But yeah, hopefully I can go find where that spark plug's been sent. I think they sent it through a bunch of hands and now it's like traipsing around different people. So coming up in Baxter, this big tree has fallen, and this is why I don't want to go do the Hunter. Almost crashed already. Like, okay, right, try and do a wheelie with no run-up. Well, I did a wheelie, and now I'm fucking beached on what I would consider... If there was a longer run-up, I could probably have just drove and wheelied over it, but look at this shit. Like, over the most tame log, what am I supposed to do if I was in a hard enduro up a hill doing this? I can't maneuver the bike properly. I'm not good enough. I need so much more practice. Yeah. And Chris did exactly the same thing I did. Although...
Oh, you did that better, though.
Yes, he definitely did that better. Definitely got some grip hook up. So, pay attention here. Yep, there was a tree in the air. And I whipped myself in the face. I didn't have my goggles on either, so I was freaking out because I was like, as I was going through the air, it was like in slow motion, this twig coming towards my eyes. I was like, ah! No, don't want that. Yeah, I put my goggles on afterwards. There was quite a lot of stuff overgrown, and then I put my goggles on. And then I get to this bit, I'm like, oh, the stewards have clearly been through here, and they've been doing some trail cutting. So, big thank you to whoever cut all of this. That was really, really cool. It made it so much nicer to ride through here. Yeah, that was great. I was getting, like, the one section before, I was like, as you saw at the start of the video, I was covered in, like, little bits of plants and all stuck to my jersey, and I was like, oh, God, can't get it off me. There were some leaves and stuff stuck in my helmet as well, and they were flapping around, and they were like making this like sound. I kept thinking there was like a four stroke coming the other way or something. I was like, what's that noise? Oh, it's just a leaf in my helmet. But yes, so today I was also practicing that person coming the other way. It was very busy today. There was a lot of people, but they all buggered off around early afternoon. I guess it was getting too hot and they all lived local. Lucky them. But yes, I was practicing that thing where I'm just trying to keep my weight low, head forwards and stuff. I say that as the clip of me is now sat down and standing up. This is getting like later. I did three laps at this point, yeah. So I was getting a bit tired. Did four laps overall. But yeah, I was trying the thing where you like lean forwards and keep your ass back and your legs down. So, sorry, not your legs down. You're like keeping your like body low and trying to keep your elbows up. I think it was working out pretty well. But by this point, I'm starting to get tired, so I'm starting to sit back down again. Yeah, I mean, each lap was... I timed one lap and it was 37 minutes. Not quite the 35 minute rip, but right now it's a lot more overgrown, so you can't really send it as much because... I can't see what's coming the other way, but I was trying to do that thing as well, also, that I see in the races, where every time there's a tiny bit of anything, just give it a little bit of throttle to try and get a bit more speed, rather than just cruising gently. And like, yeah, sure, it doesn't add much, but if you add, I don't know, I'm assuming if you add 3k here, 3k there, and you can control the bike without crashing, like, you know, the half... One third of a second down each straight, the next thing you know, you've done three straights, you gain a second. Like, that's... Plus, like, obviously, the people that do that, I see, are way better at turning and and everything added together, so they all razz off. But you know, little baby steps. Gotta practice the basics. Still practicing the basics before I go throw myself in a hard enduro. That's a completely different ball game. Much slower pace race, I guess. But I mean, I'm looking forward to seeing everyone's videos and whatever people post up about that, so that I can figure out how to practice and learn to be able to do an event like that. So yeah, I think that'll do for this week. See ya.